I welcome you all in the next video tutorial of pharmaceutical microbiology. As we have started unit number 5 and completed the topic of spoilage and preservation of pharmaceutical products. Now in this video tutorial we are going to start another topic of unit number 5, that is the animal cell culture. So let's start. For this topic I am using the presentation by Dr. Nagendra P. Is M.Tech in Pharmaceutical Biotechnology, and this is the reference of slideshow. So let's start. So cell culture, what is a cell culture? We have completed some parts of the culture media. So yes, we will grow cell. So cell culture can be defined as the process of cultivating cell and tissues outside the body of an organism, and that is known as in vitro. And in vivo means inside the body of an organism. Then we suppose you will do a test on the right rat or mice or rabbit or monkey or dog, that is in vivo study inside the organism. But when we talk about the in vitro, it means outside the body of an organism in an artificial environment, that is known as the in vitro space. Okay, the cell culture was first undertaken by Jose Harrison in 1907, and the Rocks in 1885 for the first time maintained the embryonic chick cell culture. As we go in some of the historical background, so you don't have to remember all the stuff, but always remember this 1907 development or discovery, that's very very important. What happened? Harrison cultivated frog nerve cells, okay, in a lymph float held by hanging drop method. Don't worry, we will cover this part in the practical also. And observe the growth of nerve cell in vitro. What he was done, he was observed the nerve cell in vitro for several weeks. Okay, so you just have to remember this, Harrison. So there are some terminologies associated with this topic. That is, what is cell line? Very very common question asked. What is cell line? What is primary cell line? What are secondary cell line? What are continuous cell line? So you have to remember at least one or two, because in our syllabus, as you can see, we have just the growth of animal cell in a culture and the general procedure for culturing this media and the application part only. We will focus upon the other syllabus. So the cell line, when the primary culture, but first of all we have to read about the primary culture then, but let's talk about the primary culture first. The primary cell culture, when cells are surgically removed from an organism. Okay, when the cells are surgically removed from an organism and placed into suitable culture environment, they will attach, divide and grow. This is known as the primary cell culture. And what is cell line? When the primary culture, this one, is subcultured and they show an ability to continuously propagate, this is known as the cell line. And what are the finite cell line? When the cells has finite lifespan. And what is continuous cell line? When the cell can grow up to infinite lifespan, this is known as the continuous cell line. So just remember these small three things: cell line, primary cell culture, finite and continuous cell line. So if we talk about the culture laboratory, yes, we know the culture laboratory must have some important requirements that should be filled up. It should have a proper corridor, proper HEPA filter, proper wash up area, proper drainage system, proper incubator, proper aseptic area. Everything should be there. So we do not go much deeper into it because I am running again, because we have to focus on our the syllabus. Just go by some of the photographs that is mentioned in this slide. That is the laminar. Yes, we know the laminar airflow is required. It is fitted with the HEPA filter and we need UV light. Yes, we need incubator facilities. Yes, we need refrigerator, we need lyophilizer. We have to deep freeze the sample, so we need lyophilizer also. Lyophilizer means it is used for the freeze drying purpose. Yes, we need sophisticated microscopes like which have a magnification up to more than 100, 200, 300. It will depend upon the sample actually. We need all the necessary equipments and materials required for culturing. Yes, we need autoclaves. We need different type of, this is centrifuge, okay, this is the microfilter, this is a filter attack. So we need all the important equipments like dry heat sterilization, okay, hot air oven, moist sterilization, autoclave, BOD, incubator, etc. So next is the tissue culture media. So if you talk about the tissue culture media, we know cells have complex nutritional requirement and they must be met to permit their propagation in vitro. So we need to have complex nutritional requirement. Only we can grow culture. It is not easy to grow a particular cell in vitro. And what has happened? Previously, scientists employed various chick embryo extract, etc. But today, a different type of concept has been evolved, which is known as the cell lines. So we have continuous cell line, finite cell lines, in which we will perform our experiments. If we talk about the requirements, so we need different type of media. You will remember at least 2 to 3 media out of this. That is, first is MEM media, that is minimum, M for minimum, E for essential, M for media. Then you will remember this word, this is the name of the scientist who have developed this media, Eggles minimum essential media, and DMEM, that is Dulbecco modified essential media, then IMDM, Iskov modified Dulbecco's media. So you will remember MEM, DMEM and IMDM. And the various nutrients required are, we need glucose, yes, carbon source is there, glucose, fats, fatty acid, lipid, phospholipid, we need ATP, amino acids in the salt form obviously, then vitamins, minerals, these all are the requirements of a particular cell. And we need also serum, and serum can provide various growth factors, hormones, cell adhesion factors and other factors needed by most of the mammalian cells. So we need this serum also. Okay, that are present in the form of, then apart from this serum, we need also FCS, FBS, CS, HS and HOS. So FBS is nothing, but these are the various type of serum containing media. So just read this, fetal bovine serum is the most common supplement in animal cell culture media. So you have to remember this FBS. We need FCS also, that is the fetal calf serum, and FBS is the fetal bovine serum. And there are some other special requirements also, that is the optimum pH range is between 7.2 to 7.4 for growing a particular mammalian cell. And we generally use phenol red is used as an internal indicator in it. Okay. Yes, oxygen is required, temperature condition is 37 degrees Celsius, humidity for cell growth, 100% humidity is essential, very important. If you talk about oxygen, then cell depend upon the glycolysis for the supply of oxygen. So for the completion of the glycolysis step, we need oxygen. And we need some special antibiotics for this particular growth, like penicillin for bacteria, streptomycin, gentamicin and nystatin. So these antibiotics will protect our cell from this particular bacteria or microorganisms. If we talk about the types of the tissue culture, then we have cell culture, explant culture and organ culture. These are very simple. So cell culture, as the name indicates, tissue from an explant is dispersed. So what is this explant? Explant is nothing. It is the growth of tissue or cell separate from an organism. Suppose you have an organism and you have isolated some part from it. And that particular part is known as the explant. Just read this. The explant is a piece of the plant tissue placed into tissue culture. This is with respect to the plant tissue culture. Means, if we talk about the plant tissue culture, we can say any piece of a plant tissue that is extracted or that is peeled out or removed out is known as the explant. Okay, suppose you have cut this leaf part and grow over here. So this is known as the explant. So what is cell culture? The tissue from the explant is dispersed into a cell suspension, which may then be cultured as a monolayer or as a suspension culture. You can remember the suspension culture. Okay. And what is the explant culture? It is the growth of the tissue or cell separate from an organism. And this is typically facilitated by use of the liquid, or you can also use semi-solid or solid growth media such as broth or agar media. But I welcome you all in the next part of the cell culture. So we have started this topic, that is the animal cell culture. So now we have started this, the types of the tissue culture. So first is the cell culture, we have completed it, explant and the organ culture. The organ culture is nothing but we have to develop the organ. Here we have to develop the explant. Okay, and here the tissue from an explant is dispersed into a cell suspension which then cultured. This is the cell culture. Don't worry, I show you the detailed photograph also. So here it is the representation of this three type of culture. This one is the cell culture, this is the explant culture, and this is the organ culture. So you will see here, so suppose as we have in our syllabus animal cell, so we will take an animal. Okay, so over here the two terms are written, embryo and egg. So first of all, you must know what is embryo and what is egg. So yes, embryo is an early stage of development of a multicellular organism. Okay, then it will undergo dissection, and finally we obtain the enzyme digestion. With the help of enzyme it was digested, it was either chopped or it was further dissected if necessary, and we will obtain three cultures, that is the cell, primary explant and the organ culture. Don't worry, we will do it in detail also. I'm going by the each and every aspect of this culture. So first, this video will give just you a brief idea, but we are going to up. I will definitely going to prepare one or two more videos regarding this, and it will clear all your doubts. If we talk about the primary culture, so when the cells are surgically removed from an organism, okay, and placed into suitable culture media or culture environment, they will attach, divide and grow. That are known as primary culture. So this is the procedure of your primary culture method. These are the continuous cell lines. Okay, we have completed it. I'm just going to show you the slides. This is a subculturing method. This is a cryopreservation, then detection of the chemical contaminants and limitations, applications. This is our in syllabus. This is a very important topic, application of the cell culture in pharmaceutical industry and research. These are we are going to cover in detail. So these are the various applications of it. These are the references. So I hope now you have an idea what we are going up to in this topic. I welcome you all in the next part of the cell culture. So in this video we are going to cover this topic from this Pharma Academy. So I found this video very, very useful regarding the animal cell culture. So as you can see, tissue culture is a general term used for removal of the cells, tissue or organ from an animal and their subsequent placement into an artificial environment. So we have to prepare artificial media for its sustainable and optimum or suitable growth. The cells are removed from an organ fragment, then separate it in single cell condition, placed into the suitable culture media, and this method is known as the animal cell culture. So I think this is very simple. So there are three basic steps to establish the primary cell culture. We have already covered this small term, that is the primary cell culture. So first step is the isolation of the cell. Yes, cell, we have to grow a cell. First of all, you have to isolate it from a particular animal. So in this step, the cells are isolated from a particular tissue of an animal. The second step is a disaggregation of the cell. As we know, you have now first step is you have isolated a particular tissue, and then we know in a tissue there is not a single cell present, there are number of millions of cells are present. Then we have to isolate or separate a single cell. So what we have to do? Yes, we have to do the disaggregation of the cell. So in this step, cells get separated from each other. Okay, this is a disaggregation, and this is achieved by two methods. So we use some chemicals, and there is a mechanical method for disaggregation also. And the chemicals, we use enzymes like trypsin, collagenase, hyaluronidase, or it may be used in combinations. And for the mechanical method, we use tissue homogenizer. Look at this, this is the tissue homogenizer. Now the third important step is to incubation of cell. Yes, you have isolated tissue, you have separated, disaggregation of cell you have done by two methods, chemicals and mechanical. Okay, and then after this disaggregation, then you have to incubate your cell that you have isolated in a suitable culture media. You will provide the optimum nutrient requirements for a particular cell, and it may sometimes vary also depending upon the type of the cell you have isolated. So yes, this is your incubators that we have used in the laboratory. So these are the examples of the incubator. So up to this point, now you have established the primary cell culture. You have established primary cell culture by using these three methods. Now the second step after the establishment of this primary cell culture is the subculturing. So what was happening here at this point, let me go a bit back a bit. So at this point you have incubated yourself. Okay, then what you will do, you will supply all the nutrients over this point. What you have done, by maintaining optimized culture condition to grow isolated cell, so you will provide all the nutrient requirements over here. And what is this in subculturing, what we have to do? So when the cells of the primary culture has grown up and achieved a proper growth, okay, they are then subcultured to give them more nutrient support. This is known as the subculturing. Because suppose जब आपके cells आपने grow किए, आपने उनको culture media दिया, तो होगा क्या, आपके cells जितना भी आपने culture media दिया है उसको वो consume कर लेंगे, और कुछ समय बाद उस culture media जब consume हो जाएगा तो cell और जरूरत है grow करने की, because उनकी nature है, totipotent cells हैं, they are need to be grown. So we have to provide the fresh media. That is nothing but subculturing method. In simple language, I am telling you. Okay. So after some time, look at this. Of primary culture, the cell consumes the provided nutrients. And due to this, the lack of the nutrient cell growth becomes stagnant and leads to death maybe. Thus to maintain this cell viability mean, taki cell jeevit rahe, living rahe, cells are then transferred into the fresh culture media. This is known as your subculturing. And for subculturing, the cells from the primary cell culture are harvested, isolated and transferred to the fresh culture media. But before it must be preserved in a DMSO, this is a chemical, or the glycerol by cryopreservation, because we know cryopreservation means lyophilization, freeze drying. This is nothing. You have to prepare your cell, then you have to freeze drying it. Otherwise, it will get spoiled or contaminated. So we will use a cryoprotectant agent, that is the DMSO, dimethyl sulfoxide. Okay, so you have to put your cell over here in DMSO solution. That is nothing but is a cryopreservation technique, means you have to put your cell into freeze condition so that it will remain viable or living. So just see again. So first of all, you have isolated cells. Okay. You have, first step is to isolate itself. Then, yes, we will go for the culturing. Then, yes, subculturing is done. Then again subculturing is done. Then again subculturing is done. But up to how much extent we have to do subculturing? At one point, just pause. When we obtain the proper viability of the cells, subculturing is a continuous method. Okay, it will depend upon the situation. Sometimes we have to carry out 3 times subculturing or 4 times subculturing also. So to obtain the optimum cell viability, if subculturing is done. So let's recall again what is primary cell culture. So when the cells are surgically removed from an organ and then placed into suitable culture media, they will attach, divide and grow. This is known as the primary cell culture. So this is basically the first step of the cell culture, and this is called the primary cell culture. Okay, and we have already completed the points also over here. Isolation of the cells, then disaggregation, because over here cell is not a single cell, it is a mixed, it is a combination of millions of cells. So we have to disaggregate the cells by using two methods, chemical and mechanical. In the chemical method, we use enzymes, and the mechanical by using tissue homogenizer. It is a physical method basically. With the help of physical forces, we can remove the cells. Then, very important point, after this point, incubation of the cell in the suitable media. So these are the steps of the primary culture. There are another type of culture, that is established cell culture. What is this established cell? It is nothing but it is extensive subculturing. Just read this line. When the primary cell lines continues to grow and divide their subculture, okay, in a fresh media and maintain their viability and growth. We have already covered this point. After many subculturing, about 70 times, you can see here, 70 times they are known as the established cell lines. So over in this established cell line, we can maintain the viability of a cell. And what is the advantage of this established cell culture? Primary cell culture lines grow very slowly, but established cell lines, they grow very faster. So we need faster results. That's why we go for the established cell culture rather than primary cell culture. So what is this transformed cells? It is nothing but again subculturing. So with the subsequent subculturing, if you do subculturing more than 80 times, then what was happen? The established cell lines, they become immortal. That means the cells have capacity to grow indefinitely, and there are some changes occur in the cells. So the normal cells have a limited growth capacity, but some cells acquire capacity of the growth for indefinite time. Okay, so due to their changes in the in some genetic makeup, we can say they are known as the transformed cell. So that this capacity is generated due to transformation of the genetic material, and due to this transformation, cell lose the sensitivity to external stimuli and also sometimes show changes in the chromosomal number. That is why they are known as the transformed cell, because over here, by doing subculturing of more than 80 times, there is a change in the chromosomal number of the cell also. That's why they are known as the now transformed. They become transformed. Okay, so I hope this will give you a brief idea. We have covered this point of the primary cell culture, isolation, disaggregation, incubation, and then we have covered the established cell culture, yes, culturing 70 times, and we have also seen the transformed cell in which the changes in the chromosomal number will appear. So, I'll see you in the next part. Thank you for your patience and listening. And lastly, I acknowledge the Pharma Academy for this wonderful, knowledgeable presentation. Thank you. I welcome you all, yes, in the topic of the animal cell cultures. So far, we have covered, yes, again, we are repeating. We have seen the basic steps for establishment of the primary cell culture. Then we have also seen the established cell culture, then the transformed cell culture. Now let's see the steps in the, because we have a procedure over here, general procedure for cell culture. So let's see the steps involved in the cell culture or animal cell culture. So first of all, we will take an animal. Then organ is, from this organ we obtain the tissue. Over here, this is not a single cell, it's a combination of cell. So with the help of this various chemical or the mechanical method, we can do what procedure? Yes, disaggregation. Now after that, with the help of various, suppose here you use the different type of enzymes like trypsin, collagenase, we can obtain single cell. Now we have to grow it in a suitable culture media, and we will do the subculturing also. But before that, it is known as the primary cell culture, and then we will do subculturing 70 to 80 times, then it will become your established culture. And thus we will again culture, and the cell become immortal. Its lifespan is increased. Its viability is increased, and that is known as your transformed cell culture. So you have to draw this flowchart in your examination also. This is very, very simple and very, very important also. Let me pause a bit. You can recall again. Wait a second. Thus, organs, cell fragment, tissues, enzyme digestion of cell fragment, single cell is obtained. Then there is a primary culture, culturing of the single cell in the suitable culture media. Then if you do subculturing around 70 to 80 times of the primary culture in a suitable culture media, it becomes established. And more than 80 subculturing, there is an alteration in the cell characteristics or the chromosomal number. We can call it as a transformed cell culture. Okay, so I think this point is clear to you now. So now talk about the types of the culture media used in the animal cell culture. The first one is the natural media, and second one is the artificial media. So if we talk about the natural culture media, so As the name indicate, natural. So means all the ingredients in this we use natural. Just read this. Media components are from the natural origin, and that provide the sufficient nutritional support for proliferation of animal cells. For example, we use clots, biological fluids, and tissue extracts. So if we talk about the clots, this is the which type of clots are used, how this clot is prepared, how the biological fluids are prepared, how the tissue extracts are prepared. This is very simple explanation over here. Yes. So plasma clots are prepared by mixing 15 drops of plasma plus 5 drops of embryo extract in a watch glass. Okay. And how this biological fruit, there are different type of biological fruits they use, like amniotic fluid. I hope you heard about this amniotic fluid also. Pleural fluid, aqueous humor from the eye. So these type of fruits are frequently being used. Okay. Then tissue extract. We obtain chick embryo extract is the most commonly used, but bovine embryo extract is also used. Yes, this is chick. This is bovine. And here it is the plasma. And this is the plasma. It is a liquid portion of the blood, make up to 55% of the blood. Okay. This is an element of blood. Plasma is up to 55% of, we need plasma. So the second type of media we need for the growth of the animal cell is the artificial media. As the name indicate, we use artificial substances. Like they are chemically synthesized serum containing media or serum free media also used. Serum containing media or serum free media. Chemically defined media, protein free media. And the synthetic media were prepared artificially by adding nutrients like organic or inorganic nutrients, vitamins, salt, oxygen, carbon dioxide, then serum protein, carbohydrates and cofactors, etc. There is a huge ingredients that are added in the artificial media. So if you look at the serum containing media or serum free media, so when the synthetic media, because we know these are the artificial media, so known as a synthetic. So I welcome you all in the next video. So we have started the animal cell culture and we are up to this serum media or serum free media. So as the name indicate, it is does not contain any serum. So it is serum free. It is devoid of, means it is free from any serum. So it contains serum. So don't go much detail into it. Just you have to remember about the artificial media, synthetic media, two types, serum and serum free media. So now let's talk about the cell culture techniques, because we will do some of the methods also, because the general procedure is given of primary established and transformed cell culture. So we will do not have the techniques in our syllabus directly, but we'll go at once. What are the different cell culture techniques? So there are two types, encourage dependent and encourage independent. Very simple. So what happened? Some tissue cells need attachment for the growth, are encourage dependent. So some of the tissue cell, they need a growth, they need an attachment basically for the optimum growth, for example cells from the kidney. And the, all the normal tissue derived cells are the encourage dependent cells and need surface or any support for their optimum growth or optimum proliferation. Only then they will grow. So they need a support. And the normal cell required cell-to-cell signaling system. If we do not provide any growth to the normal cell, that is for the cell from the kidney or the brain cells, nerve cells from the brains, they will not grow, because they will only grow if we provide them some encouragement, okay, some support. And they need the signaling also, they need the signaling interaction also, cell communication, they will communicate with each other. That's why they need the growth. For particular, then they will only grow if you provide support. They need support. Encouragement means support. Second is the encourage independent. For example, lymphocytes. So they do not require any attachment for its growth. And they do not attach to surface of the culture cell vessel and are encouraged independent cells. Okay. Over here, they need some support for this, for their growth. इन द कल्चर मीडिया इन द पर्टिकुलर मीडिया बट दे डू नॉट रिक्वायर एनी ग्रोथ. कौन से वाले एनकरेज इंडिपेंडेंट एज द नेम इंडिकेट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लिम्फोसाइट. जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट. नाउ सी ओवर हेयर सपोज दिस इज अ लीवर एंड यू हैव आइसोलेटेड सम सेल्स फ्रॉम द लीवर. तो यू हैव आइसोलेटेड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू आइसोलेट नॉट द सेल यू विल आइसोलेट द टिश्यू. And here, these are the cells, these round ones, but this is the collagen that will also known as cell cement. This will hold the cells. What will happen? We will now, the main primary step is to add the enzymes. Now see again, isolation. After isolation, we will add some chemicals like enzymes so that it will disaggregate. So then you can see here, this will form. And suppose you have isolated, then you will grow the normal cells or the also known as the stem cell with the help of anchorage dependent methods, or the myeloma or cancer cell can be grown with the help of anchorage independent methods. Now some people ask why we need to grow cancer cell. Yes, we need to grow cancer cell because suppose if you prepared an anti-cancer medicine, and cancer is of different types, if you prepare anti-cancer medicine of suppose a lung cancer, then how will you test it? You will need a lung cancer cell line and you will add your drug, you will test your drug in that particular lungs cancer cell lines and you will interpret your result. Suppose you have prepared the brain, you have prepared a medicine of the brain cancer. How will you test it? Yes, we have cell lines that are commercially available. You will procure cell line, that is a brain cancer cell line, there are different type of brain cancer cell lines available and you will test your drug in that. Yes, we need the cancer cell lines for the treatment, for its treatment. So, I think we have covered this aspect like growth of the animal cell, general principles, general procedure for cell culture, established and transformed cell culture. Now, we will focus upon the application of the cell culture in pharmaceutical industry and research. So, first of all, animal cell culture has several uses in the pharmaceutical industry and research as production of valuable biomolecules and in research to study cell behavior. So, yes, it is used to study different type of behavior of the cell and it is also used in the treatment of various genetic and non-genetic diseases. Second important application, yes, it is used for the drug screening and drug development. To establish the potential use of any therapeutic agent, just like we have already explained, I have already explained this. The drug screening is essential. Once the chemical or any molecule is formulated for the treatment of any disease, its efficacy potency is checked before its commercial production. So for that, we need these cell lines. We need these cultured cells. Another important application, cell-based manufacturing. The cultured cells can be used to produce many important products, like they are used to produce monoclonal antibodies that are also used against COVID, tested against COVID, insulin and other hormones. So this is the production of your monoclonal antibody. In this also, what you have isolated from this animal cells, and you will grow that cell and produce the antibody. And how will you produce this? You will inject antigen into it and antibodies are produced. Now the COVID vaccine is also based upon the same principle. What is the plasma therapy? You all have heard about this plasma therapy. The plasma of patient is donated. Which type of patients are selected? The COVID infected patient, and they have already recovered from this COVID infection because antibodies are already produced in their blood, in their plasma. So we are using that particular plasma for treatment of other patients. That is the simple principle. Very important application, yes, production of vaccines. The cells are used to produce vaccines. And their number of vaccines are produced like polio, hepatitis, which is also a viral disease, hepatitis. Then rabies, it's a viral disease, chickenpox, etc. Yes, we have covered this, production of the monoclonal antibodies. Very important application, toxicity study. So we need the cell culture for its toxicity study, for drug development, drug discovery, etc. Widely used in cancer research. So just I'm showing you the, wait a second, just be with me because we have time. I'm going to show you the cancer cell lines. The spelling is wrong. Let me correct it. Cancer cell lines. So just me type over here. So yes, there are different type of cancer cell line. Just see this table. We have breast cancer cell lines, MCF, BL1, BL2, MSL, LAR. What is this? These are the cell lines. Because cancer is of different type. Different organs have different type of cancers. So we humans produce different type of cell lines also. Like continuous cell line, finite cell line. Just see this example. HeLa cell line is used for what? Cervix type of cancer. Then for lung cancer, we use AFA549 cell line. Then for malignant melanoma, we used A375 cell line. So I'm just showing you that because we have used different type of cell line. We have developed cell lines. Yes, widely used for virology, cultivation and study of the viral cells. It's called virology. So viruses are cultured for vaccine production, genetic engineering, and to study their infection pathology. Even during this COVID period, we were experimenting on the cell lines. Genetic engineering, yes, they are widely used in the genetic engineering. Just I am showing you an article of the coronavirus. So coronavirus is susceptibility of the different eukaryotic cell lines, means different type of cell lines are tested against this coronavirus. This is a recent article published just in May. Okay. It is published somewhat later, but you have to remember this point. Yes, this one is a recent article that is published in May, okay, in which different cell lines are tested against SARS-CoV-2. So lastly, I acknowledge this channel for preparation of this wonderful video, this knowledgeable video. I really thank the Pharma Academy for that purpose. So do not share this video because, yes, we are preparing the video only for the education purpose. So their sharing is prohibited. And also you all have signed a Google Forms also. So do not share it. Do not try to share any video of any professor. So let me show you the syllabus again. Yes, we have completed this topic now. Growth of animal cell in cell culture, general procedure for cell culture, primary established transformed cell culture applications in different pharmaceutical industry and research. So thank you for your valuable time and patience.